Hello everyone, welcome to FinDataC. Please like and subscribe our channels below. Your support means a lot to us and is well appreciated. The first step of every investment is to identify your target. Today, we are going to show you how to filter thousands of stocks in 1 second, based on your personalized criteria. After finding your favorite stocks, we'll set a stock reminder so you will be notified to buy when the stocks hit your target price. The lesson today will be divided into 2 parts, part 1 and part 2. In part 1, we'll first go through the API data subscription and then explain in details the 2 API functions, get stock filter and set price reminder. Get stock filter is used to find your favorite stocks to buy, and set price reminder will set reminders of your target stocks. So as soon as they hit the target price, you'll receive a push notification to remind you. Let's jumpstart to part 1. Before we can use the API to do all sorts of fancy works, we need to have a Moomoo account and purchase the relevant data subscriptions. We will skip the part of account registration. This can be easily done following the instructions on the Moomoo website or the app. Here we're going to do the subscription for the data package, also known as quotation packages. There are 2 ways to do the data subscription. The first way is to go to our Moomoo app, click the bottom right button, Me, then from there we can find a button called My Quote. Click that and it will take us to the data shop. The second way is to do it on our computer. Open our browser and type qtcard.moomoo.com. From the website, we can log in. Then it will take us to the subscription page. Moomoo now offers free quotation for US futures, but if we need data on the stocks, we need to buy. For stocks, the cheapest one is Nasdaq Basic, $60 per month. If we want level 2 data, we need to buy the total view, which is $160 per month. Similarly, if we want data for the Hong Kong market or the Singapore market, we can buy HKG Securities Level 2 for Hong Kong and SG Securities Level 1 or Level 2 for Singapore. As soon as we purchase the data packages, we will be able to download relevant data on our API and also see them on the Moomoo app. Now let's take a look at the 2 functions for today, Get Stock Filter and Set Price Reminder. Here, we go to the API Doc website. Then on the search bar, we type Get Stock Filter. This function can help us to filter stocks based on a number of different parameters. The 2 major parameters are market and filter list. For the parameter market, there are a few options to choose from. For instance, HK for Hong Kong market, US for US market, and SG for Singapore market. Now let's look at the 2nd parameter, filter list. This is slightly more complicated. In general, there are 3 filter conditions to choose from: simple filter, accumulated filter, and financial filter. Let's go to simple filter. Simple filter mainly uses present data as criteria. Here, we use the field stock field to set the criteria. There are a number of commonly observed criteria for us to choose from. For example, stock price, market cap, PE and PB ratio. In addition to stock field, we can also set the minimum and the maximum values. Here, for example, if we use PE, we can set the minimum as 10 times PE and the maximum as 50 times PE. The next parameter is no filter. This will always set to false by default. Next, let's take a look at accumulated filter. As the name suggests, this one uses accumulated data. Let's take a look at the stock field. Here are the options for us. We can do the change rate, the stop changing rate, the amplitude, difference between the highs and lows, and volumes, etc. The format for accumulate filter is very similar to simple filter, with one exception. It has the days parameter. For example, if we want to use 5 days volume as our criteria, after setting the stop field equals to volume, we need to set days equals to 5 to tell the computer we need 5 days of data. The third filter is financial filter. This uses common financial data published by the listed companies. We will not go into details here. If you want to find out more, just go to the page and click stop field. Recalling accumulate filters, we had an extra parameter of days. Here for the financial filter, we have an extra parameter of quarter. We can use this to identify the quarterly report data. Now let's take a look at the second formula for today, set price reminder. This function pushes reminder notification to use when our favorite stocks hit the target price. There is a similar reminder function in the app, but this reminder from the API is much more powerful. Let's go through the parameters. Code is stop code. Operation changes the operation type. You can add a new reminder, remove it, or modify it. Next, price reminder type. Let's open it. There are many options here. For example, we can use price up to set a reminder if the price of Apple rises above $100.50. Or if we prefer a rate change, we can use change rate up to set a reminder if Apple's price goes up by 20%. Let's take a look at other parameters. The reminder frequency parameter lets us choose how frequent we want to be informed. We can choose always, once a day, or once. Part 1 of the video is finished. Now we have data subscription ready for the API, and we have learned the basic format for the two API functions, get stock filter and set price reminder. Next lesson, we will put them to use and perform our task in Python. Thank you for watching. If our video helped you, make sure to like and subscribe below. Your support is essential to our next production. Have a fantastic day.